focused on that activity, it's on autopilot, you don't realize where that stretch passed. And sometimes you wonder, did I go to sleep? No, you didn't go to sleep because the car is still running and running straight, which means you went into that theta stage, you merged into the driving process. Similarly, we often go into the theta state when we are sometimes listening to a certain kind of music, the kind of music that we like. We're not aware of anything else. You're so focused on the music and suddenly you realize, oh, half an hour passed. I didn't know it was this time. And then, because you've merged into the music, there is no sensation of time. Listening to certain bhajans or any kind of music.
Very much can depend on your person.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Music is a very good way of getting into theta. Oh, yes, it does. And similar, we can merge into any kind of music, but then remember that different kinds of music have different impact. Mostly any kind of classical music is regarded to be healing music. It will bring us into a more peaceful, soothing state. But if you happen to merge into something like acid rock, for example, you can merge into it, and people do merge into it, and they do enjoy it sometimes. But remember that that kind of music has a certain purpose. The acid rock typically provokes issues, you know, issues that are deep buried in you, psychological issues that you have not acknowledged. Typically, that kind of music will remind you, provoke you to bring up those issues to the forefront. So once you've listened to it, after a while, you suddenly start thinking of things which you've buried for a whole long time, and then you wonder, why did I remember this of all things? But it's because the music provokes it. So different kinds of music have different purposes. So think about what is it that you would like to merge in. Any kind of classical music is healing. It has a natural property of healing and calming the mind. So that's a safe option. Now, one way of getting, another way that you may wish to try at home, I don't think this is a good place to try because we may not be physically comfortable here, but one thing that we could try at home is get yourself into a guided script. You may wish to write it down before you meditate so that you have it very firmly in mind, where think of sit comfortably and then think of a very beautiful, peaceful house that you would like to be in. Like, let's say a farmhouse up in the hills or a seaside cottage or any kind of a place that we associate with peacefulness, calm, enjoyment. So in a very detailed way, imagine the house and its surroundings. You can do this in a group as well, yes. However, the challenge, of course, is finding a group who is looking for the same purpose, the same reason to meditate. And when it comes to a group, silent meditation sometimes can be a little out of sync. Not everyone may be comfortable meditating silently with a group. And typically, theta works in the silent mode, at least after a while. Initially, you may hear the music, or initially you may chant, but after a while, we go into our own zones. Right? So somewhere the group may not be comfortable, unless you are sort of a group who do meditate very often. It can be easily done on your own, so it's not a very difficult process. So coming back to it, one thing we can try is visualize that house in extreme detail. Look at the colors, look at the furniture, look at the surroundings, where you are. And imagine yourself seated very comfortably in that house, let's say seated on a sofa or on a swing or any kind of a place. And seated in a very relaxed mood, nothing to do, just being by yourself. And then imagine the doorbell ringing, and when you open the door, you find a stranger. Don't imagine a person that you know, but a strange face but a very pleasant, happy face, someone that you would be very, very comfortable in, someone that you can talk about anything to. Okay, imagine that face coming in. Right? Welcome the person, seat the person. And there again, notice the details, young, old, male, female, what kind of a person is it, what kind of a face is it. But yes, intend that it's a very comfortable face that you would like to have a conversation with. Having seated that person, start sharing your thoughts. Now, we typically use this process where we need to share concerns. If we are being bothered by a particular fear, frustration, anger, irritation, any kind of a thought which bothers us and which needs a solution or which needs healing, share this thought with that person. Sometimes we find that by the time we come to this position of sharing it, we visualize so much of detail that we are in a space which is quite calm. So sometimes it's possible that you may realize that you're sharing, but you're not talking. It's not a dialogue, it's telepathic. You just know that the person's understanding what you're trying to say, and the person responds and you also hear it, but it's not physical hearing, it's more of understanding through telepathy. So let that conversation go on for as long as you're comfortable with it. At the end of it, once you realize it's done, simply give the person a hug. Let the person walk out. And eventually, once the person's walked out, become aware of your body. Start feeling your breath, feeling your hands, feet, your body. And then whenever you're comfortable, open your eyes. Normally what happens in this process is you definitely come back with a message. When that person goes out, or very often the person merges into you. And with different people have it in a different way. Some people find the person just dissipating. It's not about physically walking out, just dissipate. And at the end of it, you come back with either a certain kind of a feeling, or sometimes it's this particular kind of a message about do this or do that, or just be, things are all right. Right? And eventually come back into your physical body. Now, why does this get us into the theta state is, initially we operate at alpha here. Okay, initially when we're doing the visualizing process of seeing the house, seeing ourselves and all that, we're relaxed, but then we're operating at an alpha state. We look at details, right? We are still aware of the body. But when you start the dialogue, you're so focused on the conversation, brainwave level automatically drops. And then eventually when you come back, you slowly come back into alpha and then perhaps beta, if beta is necessary at that point in time, if there's a lot of activity happening around. Always make it a point when you're doing theta meditation initially, record your experience. It helps to write down, just to see what are the different kinds of experiences. Is there a certain pattern? Do you happen to go into a particular kind of a space, or do you keep getting a repeated message? If you are seeing a pattern, please don't ignore it. Look at it. There is definitely some message. You might. But here, remember, we're talking of sharing our concerns, not the other person's. Okay? So it helps before you do this activity, if you wish to write down if you have any particular frustration or fear at that point in time, or a particular vexing issue which has been on your mind, write it down for yourself so that you can discuss it during the conversation. The reason why I speak of this particular activity, because there are hundreds of other ways to get into theta, but this one is a very heavily cathartic process. It's a healing process, because the person that you imagine there ultimately is your higher consciousness. because that's the reason why you're able to share, and then that's the reason why you get guidance as well from that person. It's a very natural way of connecting to your higher self, right? And which is why I always ensure that you imagine someone who's come without a purpose, without an agenda. He or she's come with a smiling face, he or she's ready and willing to embrace, and there's no agenda. The person just comes and sits and says, yes, I'm willing to listen. So have that as a part of your visualization. Once you do that, it's very easy to connect and get down to theta. Yes? I'm sorry? Theta?
Mm-hmm.
Different from, yes, dream state is down in the alpha level. Now what happens in the dream state is, you're not conscious, you're not getting into it with awareness, right? When we sleep and we dream, we don't really have an intention to get into that dream. Our astral body might, but not the conscious mind. Right? You don't go to sleep with a thing that, all right, today I'll dream of this particular thing or this particular person. It just happens because astral body makes the decision, not a conscious mind. Here we are trying to get a conscious mind to make that decision. I'm sorry? Dreams are of various kinds. One level is a very basic level of dream would be where, basic level in the sense when you're in your higher delta state, there are just subconscious issues which come up in the dream. It's not about past or future, it's just issues which lie buried or concerns which you have, fears which you have, which are given a certain form and it appears in the dream. Sometimes, yes, when the astral body is traveling, then what you see as a dream is very often not necessarily past or future, but another space and time. So it could be either way. Oh yes, you can. Very much. In fact, with theta, one way of reason why we see future projections, we don't distinguish between past and future, is because for the astral body, there is no concept of time. It's a physical body which is limited. We think we can only be here at this point in time. So let's say if it is 4:45 p.m. and if my body is here, my body is only here, right? Because that's our conditioned mind. When there is no body, there is no concept of time. So whether you go to past or future, it's just a space. There is no idea of time. Time is not linear. Time is linear only in our physical, socially conditioned world. And that's a proven scientific fact that there is no past and present or future. String theory talks of it. String theory by Professor Stephen Hawking. It's proven that time is not one day after the other or 1 year after the other. We in our intelligent mind perceive it that way because it's easier for us to explain and correlate and understand it. But otherwise, yeah, you can get into past, future. It's simultaneous reality. So you can get into past or future, whichever way.